challenge for yourself, challenge for somebody else?
You know, something I have been actually doing for many years is challenging myself and failing. So nobody disputes the importance of being physically fit. In fact, whenever I write, I've discovered that our best ideas come when we walk. In fact, Abhijit Joshi and we write together, the days when we unknowingly walk for 7 hours, because great ideas are coming and we don't want to stop. So there's no dispute on, you know, something happens within our bodies when we do some kind of physical exercise. But the problem is actually, most of these things are boring. You know, going to a gym is very boring. Doing the 50% is very boring.
Being on a treadmill is boring.
Boring. So, whenever I play a sport, I feel that somehow, it's somewhere it's really competitive. So I love to play badminton. It's not that I do it very often. But I make sure that 4 days a week.
How about I have a challenge for you? 100 days from now, you'll beat Saina Nehwal. Okay, I'm exaggerating a bit. Okay, you'll beat, let me think. You'll beat Pia. I'm saying I'm going to do a challenge. Saina Nehwal probably plays badminton better than you, so that's what I'm saying. It's actually easier. So,
okay,
how about that for a challenge?
I think it.
Yeah.
Nobody
Let's
lose.
You can start playing.
Yeah. That'll be nice.
Okay.
I'll get to spend more time with him that way, no problem. I'll be happy.
We don't look at the cards.
Yeah.
Let me, I want to just come back to the theme, and I want to get Diane into this as well. The sort of theme that I was referring to earlier, which is about setting more reasonable goals for people. As I said in the last segment, a lot of people think it's everything or nothing, and that's...
You actually have more time, you suddenly have more hours in the day, you feel like you're not agreeing with me. This is something that I've discovered, and I think, okay, I have an example of a hairdresser who's been working with me for many years, and she was overweight, very, very overweight, and she's lost about 15 kilos over the last 4 months, and it's been really a mind shift. She's become more aware of what she's eating. So it's not about, I will not eat this, I will not eat that. It's just becoming aware of what you're putting inside your body, and also becoming aware of how mobile and how active you are.
Right.
So she wears a pedometer, she counts her steps. She's more interested in ensuring that she's,
okay,
her physical
so
movement.
Give it some priority. Is that everything that body boils?
You know, gradually, actually, all of us become aware when our bodies start. You know, you start feeling stressed, or you start feeling a little irritable. Everything boils down to realizing that there's something wrong with our bodies. But I'm saying, if we really teach our kids to start from an early age, which I guess is this initiative, because when we were growing up, I don't think it was major emphasis.
You standing, I mean, you know why? You know where I'm leading up to with this. We have four potential. Thinking of ending up with Vijendar, but you know, right.
So,
I thought we start with Dia.
Vijendar gets to punch me once and I get to punch him 5 times. Okay, come on, Vijendar. One good one.
Good one.
Wait.
Yeah.
Okay.
No, it's going to be tough, sir.
I'm allowing you. Come on.
No, come on.
Only, see, the theme is, Vikram, that only sports teaches you to take the blows in life with a smile.
He's not punching me. I don't know. Okay, we'll get Raju to punch.
There are plenty of guys in the crowd who are wanting to come.
Okay, all of you in the crowd can line up just after this. Why did I have to ask that last question?
Please, please. Asking questions, it's a very easy joke, right? Okay, why don't I do that? Kiske raat kya karna? That's an easy joke. So, 100% is, yeah, it's going to be like tough.
100%, I negotiated a better deal.
Back. Okay, 50, sir.
50 push-ups?
Yeah. Yay!
After 100 days.
Yeah.
A day
for 100 days.
Throughout the
day. Okay.
We'll negotiate this.
Built up to 50 push-ups.
We'll negotiate this.
I don't know. 100 days.
Okay. We'll negotiate this. We'll figure it out. But okay, I'll make you one promise. And as it's one promise I've kept for the last 6 months, I'll keep it going. I will not take that lift, which I'm telling you. Thank you. Great. Actually, I was giving myself another challenge, huh? Link, send them the link. Oh, what? I have to say. Ranbir, Kapoor, thank you so much. Ranbir, Kapoor, thank you so much for being with us. Ranbir, you've really been helping us so much in this all this time. Fitness means a lot for you, sports means a lot for you.
Absolutely, thank you so much for being here. To be honest, fitness and sports is something which makes you happy. I think it changes your life. The first thing which always I think is the issue is the knowledge of it. You know, we are so distracted by other things that we ignore this side. I don't think there's anything greater than being fit, which will keep you happy in your mind and in your head.
Great. Well, you know, one of the first things that we've been talking about is marks for sports. Somehow getting schools to pay some attention to sports. You know, people tell their kids, you know, marks, aapko marks aane chahiye, kya khel kood kar rahe ho. So how do we change that? How do we actually get, you know, sports put onto the curriculum? Now we've been pushing that for a while. We do have the Union Sports Minister with us, Sarbanda Sonowal, or we will have him in just a couple of minutes. But Devish, this is a question we've been asking people. What is it that we would like the government to do on this?
So basically, Vikram, I think it is critical that we look at sports fundamentally differently. Till we don't do that, fundamental changes will not happen. We studied countries across the globe that do well in sport, and we realized that sports is given a lot more importance than what it is in India. So fundamentally, if marks are given for sports, suddenly you will have a totally different way of looking at sports. So at 6 o'clock, instead of the mother telling the child, "Okay, beta, don't waste your time in khelne kudne mein," she suddenly say, no, 1 hour playing is very important because you'll get marks for it. So everything here is linked to marks, everything in India is linked to incentive. We need to incentivize sports and fitness to change the fitness scene in this country.
Alright. Viren, any thoughts? I mean, is this a serious problem? When you're going out there trying to get champions, when you're trying to tell people, you see a kid and see that kid and you say, that kid could potentially be getting a gold medal for India someday. And then the parents say, we don't want him or her to pursue sports, then what happens? Hang on, guys, I'm just going to interrupt ourselves. The Chief Minister just walked in. Thank you so much for joining us. It's a real pleasure to have you with us. We were just discussing this concept of sports, and the basic question is, as you were just saying, that sometimes parents don't want their children to pursue sports, even if they're a potential champion. Why? Because there are no marks for it, because it's not considered the right thing to do. So I was getting very into answer that, but maybe you want to just come in with your quick take on this?
Because I feel that parents feel that there is no career in sports in India. Actually, there is, but not every child achieves what the East players have achieved. So there is always a fear in the mind of the parents, and they want their child to go into mainstream. In Maharashtra, we have our policy, sports policy, which gives additional marks to those sports persons who cannot devote their time for studies but excel in sports. So we feel that by giving them additional marks, we ensure that they get admissions in good colleges, in the good courses. But I think we professionally need to encourage people so that they also encourage their children to go into sports. Right now, basically, we are focused on 2-3 sports only in the society. If it's cricket, you get sponsors. But it's any other sport, you don't get a sponsor, or you don't see a very bright career. So I think once we professionalize most of the sports and we create a scenario where in any sports, if you excel, then you have a good career. If this is the case, I think that people will encourage their children.
All right. Viren, you want to come in on that?
I agree with the fact that right now, actually a very minuscule proportion of our population, especially the student population, actually plays sports. If you see a lot of the